For most bone marrow transplants to be successful, the patient's own bone marrow must first be wiped out with chemotherapy and radiation to make space for the new donor cells. But this treatment is impossible for an adult with sickle cell, because over their lifetime, the disease has ravaged their organs.
You need normal organ function to be able to take the high doses of chemotherapy and radiation that a standard bone marrow transplant requires. So really the holy grail of transplant for patients with sickle cell disease is to get a bone marrow in without much toxicity that's safe and available to all patients.
Hi, Dr. Tisdale.
You work with
Dr. Shea. Oh, hey, heard your name thrown around
there.
Nice
to meet
you. How you doing? I'm Deidra.
When we meet adult patients who are coming to think about a transplant protocol, they are fed up with their disease and they're ready to do anything to get rid of it. So we have to be very careful in counseling them about the potential risks and benefits, so we make sure they understand the experimental nature of what they're getting into.
This is the part that I get to play the bad guy. I have to do this because the transplant process is a pretty big deal. And I throw out some worst case scenario that could happen.
Death.
Mm-hmm. So yes, that's definitely one of them. It's not to scare you, but you know, you do need to be informed.
Dr. Matt Shea is also part of the research team that has designed this first in human trial.
It is a big decision, so something for you to think about.
My mindset is, I'm okay either way.
Okay.
I don't want to die, but, you know, I know it's a possibility. However, I don't want to live and not take the opportunity. Do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
I'm 39 years old. I'm at peace with however this goes. I could possibly die doing this procedure, but with the odds, I could die just as quickly with sickle cell.
You get to pick what you're gonna make today. You get to pick the color. What are we gonna make?
I'm gonna make a pizza and I'm making these.
You're making me hungry. You look like a good pizza.
Like Deidra Williams, Lucy Weiss is at Building 10 to treat a disease for which currently there is no standard cure.
And now I cut it.
Lucy's Jobe syndrome has left her with an immune system that makes even the most routine infection deadly.
She unplugged her back area.
Yes.
In an attempt to give her a complete immune system, one free from Jobe's, her doctors have decided to turn to Lucy's mother, Jan, as a bone marrow donor.
The reason to do this now is that if we get a new immune system in early, we believe that that will give her time to remodel that lung and take care of it, and we may be able to avoid having to take that part of the lung out. We may not.
So what I don't know is this lymphodepleting thing that you're doing.
Yeah, the second-based regimen.
Lucy's doctors have never performed a bone marrow transplant on a Jobe's patient. Because of this, they do not know how this procedure will impact Lucy or her extremely rare and complicated disease.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. Lucy.
Lucy!
Can I say hi to you?
Hi.
How's it going?
Good.
I like what you're making. Is that dinner?
It's pizza. So this is sausage. This is ham. This is pepperoni.
Mmm. So you know Dr. Kanakri, right? And you know that she's helping to get you a new bone marrow so we can get these things all better.
As I understand, were you originally discovered the gene that causes Jobe syndrome, the STAT3?
I was one of the team here. Okay. That was involved in identifying it.
Okay.
Being able to make the diagnosis genetically early makes just 100 things possible.
Absolutely.
And in the day before we had the gene,
we
wouldn't know whether we could use your bone marrow or not. We wouldn't know whether you had it too, and whether maybe if we transplanted it, things would go sour.
For us, it's really exciting that we didn't realize that we had much hope beyond what we've been doing at this point.
Right.
It could offer her a lot of positive change.
Well, we're very hopeful too.
See you tomorrow. Thanks for coming.
See you later.
Colin.
Bye. I'll see you tomorrow.
Thanks.